to the Knox Hollow Woodshop back on the Nemesis Gear Steampunked Out channel. And I know I said that probably wouldn't do any more videos until after these shows coming up, but it turned out I needed a couple of Purple Heart wands for upcoming stock for the show. So I managed to get a quick video in, and I'm going to compress those into two wands into one video. So I kind of skipped through this first part fairly quickly because both wands are pretty, they start out the same. You get them roughed in to about the right size on the shaft. And I've got the first one started. Then we'll do the second one here. And it's just easier to do both of them on the spur drive before I switch out to these jaws here. Now, once I get the jaws done, then I can go ahead and put that first wand back in, or this second wand in here. And then we'll continue making the wand as usual. So, and I've got the other one is now sitting to the side, already prepared to go in the jaws when this one's done. So, and again, we just work the shaft down so that I can get as much of it up into the chuck as I can. And that leaves me a smaller amount here to work on for the handle so I don't get as much jitter. And that works pretty well. So these wands are, I did one that's just kind of a standard stock wand, and then I also did kind of a special edition wand that's got some carving on it. And this first one is just going to be the standard one, but the Purple Heart is just, it's a really pretty wood, but it's really popular, so I try to have a couple extra of those when I do a show, just because the demand is pretty high for them. And just a quick reminder here, closer to the beginning of the video, if you do enjoy watching these, it really helps out if you can give me a thumbs up. Also, you can subscribe, and you'll get a notification anytime they get a new video out, too. So we really appreciate you supporting the channel. And you can see we're doing that kind of a vase shape there for the handle. I really like this shape. It actually is kind of mirrored. It's kind of an elongated tulip shape, which is what the guard area is. And then we'll do some wire burning here to kind of define some of the transition lines and get that charring brushed out. And then we'll start moving to some sanding. I'll do a little bit of sanding here, and then I've got to take the tenon off the tailstock there so that we can finish getting that final handle shaped, and then, you know, the pommel sanded down and stuff too. So this shape's been really pretty popular, but thank goodness I like making it, because a lot of people like the shape as well, so they seem to sell pretty well. And then this time I'm just going to use the torch to heat up that Purple Heart and kind of bring that purple back. The first one I use the torch on, the second one I use the heat gun on. The torch, it gets really hot really fast, so it takes less time, but it does tend to darken the wood more because it works so quickly. It's harder to control exactly you know, where to stop there. See, it's harder to stop. And I did put a little bit of ebonizing fluid on a couple of spots on this just to make sure that it was nice and dark. And once I get the oil finish and stuff on here too, it does kind of darken and clean up. And I'll show you the oiled wands, both of them at the end on the final photo. I think I just kind of get this, I'll wipe this down with just some denatured alcohol to kind of clean the dust and stuff off and kind of give you a general idea of what it looks like. But then I'll go and I'll taper the shaft of the wand off and get that sanded out before I do the oil on it. So, but I'll set this aside and then kind of continue with the next one. And this one, I actually just was, I have a tough time. I'll lay in bed at night and my mind starts wandering, and I thought of this design while I was laying there. I was like, oh, I think I want to do this shape. So it's I don't think I've done one exactly like it before, but I had something in mind with some kind of these kind of like ball shapes. But as you'll see, I go in and I do some carving in those and kind of making this kind of weird organic textury thing that I really liked. But yeah, just you know, one of those things. Juan seemed to always be on my mind. So, and I'm just kind of marking generally where the middle is going to be here, so I can kind of have an even taper on this, where the grip is going to be, because it's kind of a both of them taper in towards the middle here. So once I get the shape and everything done, then we'll do the carving. I've edited out a large amount of this as well, because the carving is it's really time consuming and it gets pretty repetitive. So I try to cut these down and, you know, focus just so you can kind of see the progression without having to sit here, you know, for several hours watching every little detail. Kind of refine that shape a little bit and then sand that up all the way through the different grits. I think I'm only going to 320 on this before I do the burning and the carving and stuff. So, and then I'll do the final polishing grits and stuff after I get it all worked out. Now, this is where I'm going to mark out. I want to do some of that organic shape into the handle as well, but I want to define it, the area for it, and then leave some smooth parts. So I'm going to mark out a space for the carving, and then, you know, burn in a dividing line to kind of. The design wise, it's nice to kind of keep those organic shapes that they're going to be defined in there. You'll see what I'm talking about in a moment. So we'll get this parted off the spindle here, and then that way I can finish shaping up that kind of rounded sphere on the end. And then now we go into the Dremel carving. So, and this is one of the more time-consuming things. I would love to do more of this type of stuff, but it takes so much longer to go in and do like the hand carving and stuff. And I mean, I would do some totally hand carved wands if I could, but the time that it takes there, you know, puts the wands, they're going to be over $100, you know, if you do a completely hand carved wand. That's really detailed. I know Kaivox, all his are, you know, he does a lot of really special work and stuff on his. But I try to do some of these on the lathe. Most of the work I do on the lathe, it saves some time. And then I don't always do the fancy, you know, carving and stuff on it. And that gives me more of a price range for people, because not everybody wants a fancy wand like this. This one will be a special edition. I forgot what the prices are on. I'd have to look and see. The Purple Heartwood's a little bit more expensive, but the basic ones are, between $35 and $45. And then if I do the hand carving, then the price goes up on it. So, but I really like this kind of weird, organic-y, you know, texture shape that I'm putting in there. And then I'll go in and we'll heat this with the heat gun, which takes longer, but I can get a little bit more control on the coloring. So, and then I'm just wiping off all the dust. But I am going to use the ebonizing fluid on the carved parts, because I want those to be nice and dark. In the grooves where I've carved it out, I want those to be nice and dark. So once I do this, I'll sand it a little bit. So it all actually ended up being fairly dark in the end, but you can definitely, and it's harder to see in the pictures than it is up close. With the heat gun, like I say, it takes a little bit longer to do. So I've got some time lapse here, so you can see the progression of it. As you can see, it's starting to darken that purple up, and then of course the where it's ebonized, it's just going to be almost black. And you can sand part of this back out, so it doesn't, the ebonizing fluid, you know, if you sand that, it only goes so deep into the wood, so you can kind of sand some of that back out and bring some of the color back if you get it too dark. So I haven't I don't know if you can do that if you put it in the oven, because I would imagine the oven heats it more evenly throughout, and I don't know if it has to do with this heat solely or if it's the heat and oxidation both. So I'd be be an interesting test to do. I just find it's a lot easier to use a heat gun or a torch or something as opposed to putting it in the oven to bring that color back out. So, but as you can see here, it's turning out to be a pretty good looking design. I'm doing the final wipe off here, get all the sanding dust off, and then we're going to do this oil. This is what it looks like with the oil finish on it. And then once the linseed oil dries on these, I've got a final picture here of the, once I get the wax on it and stuff. These are not going to be on my Etsy store, at least not until I get back from the next show. I just don't see a need to take pictures of these if they're going to go to a show and sell here in a couple weeks. So if you want to catch me at Norwescon, then they'll probably still be there on the first day, but just, you know, depends. I've got quite a few wands in stock, but they can be really popular and they'll get sold out pretty quickly. But any of the ones that don't sell will go right back up on Etsy and I'll get those listings done. But anyways, there it is. Two wands in less than 15 minutes. One of them was even a fancy wand. So I hope you enjoyed this. Don't know that I'll have time to get any more done before the end of the month. We'll be going to Norwescon, so we'll be there for a few days in SeaTac. If you're there and you like the videos, make sure you mention it when you come by the booth and say hi. You can kind of check out the wands in person, plus all the other leather stuff I have. I've got tons and tons of stuff that I don't even think I've got videos for all the stuff that I make. So, and we're also closing out some things too that I'll probably just do made to order from now on, so there'll probably be some sales going on. Anyways, we hope to see you at the show, and definitely don't forget to give us a thumbs up and like the video. It really helps us out, and we'll catch you as soon as we get back. Thanks for watching.